Best Musical Moment, presented by Sonic. Heartstopper, Dance With Me.
And the golden popcorn goes to, can I get a drum roll, please? Dance With Me, Heartstopper. Congratulations, Heartstopper. I am honored to accept this award on your behalf.
I feel so honored to be seen as a queer person in general, and to be here right now on the stage is a step forward to opening doors for other trans people in the industry. And I just remember younger Yasmin, and she never had the representation that I get to give. This is for all the younger Yasmins out there that never had the representation that I get to give. And I'm just so happy to be able to be that person that people look up to and get to see themselves through the screen. And they look at Elle and they think, that's me. I never had that. And I'm just so happy to accept this award. I'm happy to be here with attitude and to have the attitude. And yeah, it's such a surreal moment. I'm hoping that with everything I'm doing with Doctor Who, with Heartstopper, I get to open doors for not only me, but for other queer people that want to be in the industry, because we all deserve a seat at the table. And yeah, this award isn't just for me, it's for everyone that wants to be in the industry. Thank you, and I can't wait for you all to see the trans magic coming to your screens in 2023. Thank you.
Did you go out with someone who wasn't a girl?
I don't know.
This award isn't just for me, this is for all of the trans community. Thank you to my mom, thank you to my dad, everybody.
Hello everyone.
Hello.
What? Thank you so much. What an absolutely beautiful introduction. I'm a little bit emotional, to be honest.
I got teared up. We're all so surprised with the impact Heartstopper had, because when we were making it, it was our little show that was like our family and our community, and then it being out in the world and seeing so many people. I think Netflix is such a perfect platform for it, because it reaches countries that aren't as far on their journey of acceptance as we are, and those young queer kids can still watch our show. And yeah, and these two are going to thank people who are important, because I'm going to forget someone.
Good. Thank you. Thank you. I'm sorry.
We want to say a few thank yous. We want to thank Eros Lin, our wonderful director, who really guided us through the whole process. We want to thank the wonderful Alice Osman for creating all the characters, for creating the world of Heartstopper, such a joyous and celebration of a place. We want to thank everyone at Netflix for broadcasting the show and Seesaw for producing the show. Thank you so much, guys.
Hello.
It's not the first time I've been here, and seeing everyone's face tonight really... Okay, so I want to thank the Attitude Awards family for always pushing the show and making us feel so comfortable every time we come here. This was pretty much our first ever red carpet, and this time last year we was here, and I just can't thank you enough, so thank you. I'd also like to thank my beautiful mum who's out there watching. Your love. Your love and your support through the darkest times of my transition really helped me, and I really appreciate that. Thank you so much. I love you. I think I speak for 99% of this room when I say that we all needed a Heartstopper growing up. Period. And I'm just so happy that we get to be that representation for the new generation to come, and they get to finally have happy, positive, natural representation they deserve.
Just someone I can have a laugh with, and he's nice and kind and likes being with me.
For you.
Oh.
Is it their secret boyfriend or the straight boy crush?
And the winner of the best new drama goes to
Heartstopper!
So the cast are currently on set, and they've sent us this this very short message.
Fantastic.
Thank you, Teen Choice Awards.
Thank you.
Joe and Kit were thrown into the limelight with Heartstopper, which we all love, right? It's huge, so congratulations. Adam said that you are the most interacted with GQ cover in 33 years in its history. Like, you should be incredibly proud of what you've achieved, and thank you so much for being the talented men that you are. So please give it up for Joe and Kit.
Firstly, the fact that Paul has just introduced us is insane to me. Literally, over the last year, I don't know how many times I've watched normal people. This isn't normal. I'm really not very good at this, so I'm gonna make it quick. It's not normal. I feel like it will never ever feel normal. We're sitting in a room full of people who, we admire so many people who I'm just like, how am I in the same room as you? And you've got to feel okay. You know what I mean? I don't know. I'm going to be an absolute prick and leave Joe to do the rest of it.
This time, 2 years ago, I sat in my bedroom in the Isle of Man thinking I was going to go to uni and study law. Now I'm here. So, yeah, I think we want to thank GQ, first of all, because giving us this opportunity. Heartstopper meant so much to us personally and so much to a lot more people in the world than we thought it would. And it's been so great to be a part of a show that's just meant so much to a lot of people who haven't felt that they've seen themselves on screen. And I hope that our show is, and many of the shows that they made now, are kickstarting a trend of creating more queer television, because that's, and movies, and because that's what we need. And yeah, I mean, I know what I'm saying. So.
The Gay Times honour for on-screen trailblazer, presented by Copra, goes to Heartstopper.
Congratulations.
Wow. I'm Kizzy. This is Karina, and we play Heartstopper's lesbian couple, Gay Times. Gay Times, thank you so much for such a wonderful evening so far, and thank you so much for this award. Thank you, Netflix, for facilitating Heartstopper, and Cecil and Patrick Walters for making it real. Thank you so much. Thank you, crew and cast, for being such a safe space when all of this was so new. And special thanks to Kit and Joe, our incredible superstar boys who are such spectacular leads. Thank you, Eros Lin, a kind, brilliant, talented man who got the best out of every single cast and crew member. Thank you, casting at Daniel Edwards, for giving all the cast the opportunity to become such lifelong friends. Thank you, Alice Oseman, the creator of Heartstopper. I cannot believe your creativity and your resilience. And thank you to the fans. You are fantastic and good people, and we are so grateful.
Shalom from Tel Aviv. The award goes to Yasmin Finney, who's had a huge impact as Elle Argent in the Netflix series Heartstopper, and will be joining the cast of Doctor Who in 2023. She's one of the most influential actresses in the transgender community and is also known for her groundbreaking TikTok videos where she shares her life experiences, which have been watched more than 12 million times. Many congratulations, Yasmin.
Hello everyone, it's me, Yasmin Finney. Thank you so much for appointing me the Emerging Talent Rose Door Award. It means the most to know that the roles that I play not only give representation to a community that's needed it for so long, but it's being celebrated and rewarded. So thank you guys so much again. Bye.
Hi, I'm Adrian Swift and greetings from Sydney. Let's have a look at the finalists in this hotly contested category.
Would you kiss me?
It was a huge search with very little time. Social media was our first port of call because we had to go out very wide to the young queer community very, very quickly. So we used Instagram and TikTok and it went ballistic. They crashed my website 5 times and we had over 10,000 submissions, 6,000 self-tapes, but there was an end arrow down to 2 sets of groups. And a really, really kind of intense but beautiful chemistry reading session. But it was a long, short process, paradoxically, and 12-hour days, 7 days a week, and just having a fantastic source material to kind of work from. So I feel very, very proud of all the cast and everybody who auditioned, really, and my team.
And the Emmy goes to...
Heartstopper!
Accepting the Emmy is Daniel Edwards.
I've got a boyfriend.
Oh, well, congratulations. Oh, thank you so much. I've got terrible jet lag, so I don't even know what my name is. It's my birthday today, I can't quite believe. I'll be brief. I'd like to thank Netflix and Seesaw for the gig. I'd like to thank Lucy, Tom, Catherine, Dane, who are my amazing team back in London. I'd like to thank my partner, my husband, Paul. I'd like to thank my cohorts for Heartstopper. And I'd like to thank all the 10,000 submissions that we had for this incredible show. And one last thing I'd like to say, for every single person from the LGBTQI plus community around the world who've taken this incredible show to heart, it gets better. We see you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Here are the 7 nominees for Outstanding Makeup and Hairstyling.
Heartstopper, Netflix.
And the Emmy goes to... Heartstopper!
Accepting the Emmy is Patrick Walters.
Okay, you better come in, or Nelly will think we're going for a walk.
Hi, guys. I'm Patrick. I executive produced Heartstopper, and I work with Alice, who's the writer, and I'm accepting this award on her behalf. She gave me a message to read out, and she says, "Thank you so much to the Children and Family Emmys for this award. Heartstopper was a team effort, and I would like to thank the entire cast and crew for their hard work and for the passion for a story that is so precious to me. Creating Heartstopper is one of the greatest joys of my life, and it means so much to know that so many people around the world have enjoyed it too. Thank you so much."
Olivia Colman as Sarah Nelson, Heartstopper, Netflix.
And the Emmy goes to... Olivia Colman as Sarah Nelson!
Accepting the Emmy, Patrick Walters.
Oh, I love you.
Olivia really is that lovely, so I will make sure she gets this Emmy. And yeah, we can't believe she said yes to our show, so we still can't believe it. So thank you, Olivia. Thank you.
Yasmin Finney as L.R. Jett, Heartstopper, Netflix. William Gao as Tao Su, Heartstopper, Netflix. Kit Connor as Nick Nelson, Heartstopper, Netflix. Joe Locke as Charlie Spring, Heartstopper, Netflix.
And the Emmy goes to... is Kit Connor as Nick Nelson, Heartstopper.
Accepting the Emmy is Kit Connor.
Anything to do with you, I just don't think we really fit together.
Whoopi Goldberg, what?
Kit isn't here, and Patrick, who was supposed to be picking up the award for him, has just picked it up for Olivia. So we've just jumped up here, but
Kit, wherever you are, hi.
Yeah, Kit was just, he's been so inspiring for us, and he really led the company of actors, and this is so well deserved. And yeah. I can't wait to give this to him.
Yeah.
Thank you. Well done, Kit.
And the Emmy goes to Heartstopper.
Accepting the Emmy, Patrick Walters.
One of the most amazing things about producing Heartstopper was working with an exceptional young cast. I've got Joe, Will and Bash with me today, but I also need to shout out Kit, Yasmin, Kizzy, Karina, Toby, Rhea, Jenny and Cormac. I'm so proud of all of them. They're all amazing. There's no Heartstopper without the creative genius that is Alice Oseman, and the show wouldn't have been what it is without the talent and vision of our director, Eros Lynn. I want to thank them both. I also need to thank Netflix, especially Dominique, Alexi and Will, who's here today. They believed in the show from the very beginning when they really didn't have to. I also need to thank my producing partners, Arana Piggott and everyone at Seesaw Films. Most of all, with Heartstopper, we wanted the next generation of LGBTQ plus kids to see themselves in a story about queer joy, about love, and about acceptance. So I really want to thank the Television Academy for recognising our show because it means the world to us. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Alice Oseman, and I'm the Attitude 101 Person of the Year.
How does it feel to be a new, more inclusive, best-selling children's author who actively promotes and supports the community?
Oh my gosh, that is a big question. I mean, I feel like I'm just making a series that I love to make, and it started as a passion project, and it still is. So the fact that so many people around the world have connected to it and have enjoyed it is like a really special thing, because people are loving it as much as I love making it.